Who knew an updated keyboard could be such a huge upgrade? Apple has done some simple redesigns on its MacBook Pro and made it the most exciting upgrade we've seen in years. Not only have they given us a normal keyboard, but we also got a slightly larger display and a physical escape key. Apple says this updated Mac is all about listening to the customer, but have they listened to us and updated its repairability? We're gonna say no, but just in case, let's tear it down. The same series of P5 Pentalobe screws holds the case in place, and with some force, we're able to unlatch the rear case. Turns out, we're dealing with pretty much the same internal design as before. There's not much here but a giant battery and a logic board. There are tons of cables and just as many screws to remove, but then the logic board and heatsink lift right out. Underneath the heatsink, we find the 2.6 GHz 6-core Intel Core i7, paired with the AMD Radeon Pro 5300M. We also spot the 16 GB of DDR4 SDRAM and the 512 GB of solid-state storage. As with previous models, all of these chips are integrated into the logic board, making upgrades impossible. No surprise here, but disappointing like always. What's this? We actually find some modular parts. Both the newly redesigned fans and right and left Thunderbolt ports can be removed and replaced. These fans are part of the new, improved thermal design of this MacBook Pro. They've been retooled to bigger impeller blades, allowing them to push through 28% more air. The remainder of the upgrades are firmly glued to the case. We spot the newly redesigned and awesome sounding speakers, and of course the battery, which is now rated at 99.8 watt hours, just shy of the FAA's allowed to fly battery limit of 100 watt hours. So with all these upgrades, has the repairability score changed for the 16-inch MacBook Pro? Nope, it scored a 1 out of 10. And here's why. On the upside, the trackpad can still be removed and replaced with very little drama. But on the downside, minor components are modular, but the processor, RAM, and flash memory are soldered to the logic board. Glue and rivets secure the keyboard, battery, speakers, and touch bar, making those components a tricky fix. And the Touch ID sensor is the power switch and is locked to the logic board, complicating repair. And if you're still wondering about that new keyboard, we did a deep dive into its new, yet old, scissor mechanism on our First Look livestream. And if you're totally in the dark about why these keyboards are such a big deal to begin with, we have another video explaining why the butterfly mechanism was so terrible and all the things Apple had to do to try to fix it.